A lot of people will tell you that you have to do keyword research. Other people will tell you how the data isn't accurate in the keyword research tools, so why bother? I think keyword research is a good idea. After all, you need to have topic ideas that people are looking for, or you're probably not going to get any traffic from Google, which is usually what people want to do. Now, I'll readily admit that keyword search volumes are estimates at best. And yes, I know I have this keyword golden ratio formula that relies on the search volume. Somehow that formula has been working great for several years, even though the numbers aren't exact and they're just estimates. So let's ignore that for now and look at a way to find keywords that is free and it omits the search volume and it works for any niche. It's the auto-suggest feature on the Google search, and it also works on YouTube. So let's look at a demo here and find some real keywords that will work. We can come up with a few root keywords to start from, like maybe roof boxes, DSLRs like cameras, and Canon lenses. So those are the things we're gonna look at, and we'll find some really nice keywords. We're gonna look at a couple main areas here. I mentioned we're gonna take a look at roof boxes, DSLRs, and Canon lenses. And it'll give you a few ideas on what you could do. And I'm doing roof boxes because one of my friends, Alex, over at WP Eagle, he has like a public site that he's been building. It's earning money. I've torn down the site and audited kind of what's going on. So you can check out some of the details there, but we'll just start at the beginning and type in, roof box for a car, for sale, storage hooks, some different things for Subaru Outback. All right, so that's kind of cool. So I'll just do roof box for Subaru Outback. So just with autocomplete, we've gotten some good ideas already, but let's type in best roof box for Subaru Outback. Okay, nothing else is coming up with auto-suggest here, but here's the cool thing. Best roof box for, and then we have something cool that's happened here. I see two things that you should pay attention to. We have specific types of cars like Subaru Outbacks, Foresters, Crosstrek, Subarus are super popular, but we also see some other brands. So we have Volvo, Toyotas, we have a Honda CR-V, and so on. And what you realize here is you can do this for any kind of car. And that's one of the reasons why Alex liked this niche, because it really expands out in a cool way. But the second thing that I observe is there are specific roof boxes for certain applications, like holding skis. So at this point, we may, search for skis. Best roof boxes for skis, and there's not much else coming up there, but let's, stick in the winter sports idea. So we have snowboards. You can also think about just maybe like luggage. So there's a couple other things, and I don't have a roof box. I haven't thought about it too much. So I don't know other things that you would put into a roof box, but maybe you could figure that out. Maybe you can go look around and check to see what you can find. Now, another thing that comes up is, let's say we stick with the roof box, but instead of best roof box by itself, we'll look for a specific brand. So maybe we'll do, I saw Yakima show up there. So best Yakima roof box pops up. Best cargo box. So there's some other iterations that are popping up. So this is pretty useful, I think. And there may be other names. So we have a roof cargo box for Subaru Outback. So what happens if we take that off? So we have luggage, SUVs, 4Runners, some different ideas. What if we take off roof and just say best cargo box? We have Prius. So all of a sudden you're getting more and more ideas. All this just through Google auto-suggest. So fairly straightforward. I don't know any other specific types of things that you would put into a roof box. So I'm kind of hitting the end of my expertise on that. But what we can look at also is this DSLR. So maybe we do best DSLR. And then we have under 500, under 1,000. And we have for streaming, for beginners, for video. So let's do for astrophotography. So we have astrophotography and cloudy nights. We have budget DSLRs. We have a few other details. And then here's actually a informational type article. So the best DSLR settings for astrophotography. So this is informational, even though it's in the format of what I would refer to as a buyer's keyword. So it's kind of interesting. Now, what else can we see? What are the best DSLR settings when you take off astrophotography? So now we've just found a bunch of informational keywords that are perfect for this specific keyword here, this niche. And what if we put in, instead of DSLR settings, what if we put mirrorless? So it's a different kind of camera. So mirrorless camera, best settings for mirrorless camera, best video settings. So there's other options here. And once you start looking, you just find more and more of these. Now, speaking of how to, maybe we can do DSLR settings and just put in how to. And, you know, it's kind of a weird way to type it in, but this happens on Google all the time. So we may be able to see just other keyword ideas, maybe, and what other people ask. So this is a useful way just to dive in and find how-to topics. Okay, and speaking of cameras, let's just look at Canon lenses, and we'll say Canon lenses 4, and then we end up with a lot of different applications. So we have landscape. We have portraits. I saw astrophotography, wedding photography, sports, wildlife photography. We have Canon lenses for the M50, which is a specific type of camera. So you could go that route too. And basically what happens is you'll see that there's a lot of different ways, a lot of different forks in the road that you can take here once you start poking around. This is all just free on Autosuggest. And the magic here is Google is telling you that people are searching for this. Their algorithm knows what people are looking for. And a lot of times when people type in Canon lenses 4, you may see these different options. And that's why it works so well. It's pretty cool. And Google is literally telling you what people are searching for because it's a common thing that people have searched for. It doesn't take into account search volume at all. So for the folks that are worried and you're thinking, hey, the search volumes are not accurate, KGR seems like maybe it's a weird idea, fine. You can ignore the KGR. You can use Autosuggest and find these sort of hidden gems that maybe other marketers like us are not searching for because we're using keyword research tools and we're looking at the search volumes. But if you just use Autosuggest, you can remove that layer of complexity and you'll literally just see what people are searching for. I mentioned that you can do this on YouTube as well. So let's hop over there and check it out. So we're just in an incognito window and we literally can look for some of the same kind of things. So we'll do best DSLR 4. And then again, we see all of these different suggestions. So it's a little different, right? So people on YouTube search for some different items. So on YouTube, people watch vlogs and they may want to record them if they're a YouTuber themselves, or maybe they want to get into it. So maybe this is the perfect one. So best vlogging, best DSLR for vlogging. Then you have some other iterations that pop up here. So for 2020, under 100, under 500, best Sony vlogging camera and GoPro for vlogging. They give you all the ideas. You literally can create videos or blog content, written word on these topics. Google is telling you, YouTube is telling you that people are searching for these. You want more ideas on finding keywords that will rank fast? Check out the videos on the keyword golden ratio. If you haven't downloaded the KGR spreadsheet, it's free. It makes things easier and you can get the link in the description. I'm Doug Cunnington and you could subscribe to this channel for more videos on keyword research and making money online.